All right, stay tuned to a Gen Con. We're here with Robert of Darkson Designs. And he's here to tell us about AE-WWII and the other great things coming out from this company.
So my name is Robert Kingery, K-I-N-G-E-R-Y. I'm the creative director of Darkson Designs. We've actually got two games out right now. We've got AE-WWII, which is an alternative events World War II game set in 1946. Storming the beaches of Normandy have failed. MacArthur is president. We got a bunch of weird stuff going on. You got Nikola Tesla creating devices for the Americans. You've got genetic experimentation going on for the Germans, the SDs. For the Soviets, you have a psychic awakening of the Soviet population through the Tunguska blast.
Cool.
We just released our second book, which is the occult expansion. Everybody's been waiting for it. The darn thing's cursed, definitely.
Yeah, you guys have been having some problems with it, huh?
Issues with printing, layout, design, absolutely anything there we could possibly think of. But it's finally getting out to the fans right after Gen Con, we're shipping it out. That covers the SS, which I know a lot of people are clamoring to get a hold of. You've got werewolves, vampires, you've got these creatures that are the ghosts and spirits of World War I veterans roaming the fields.
Awesome.
For the SS. For the Americans, they've decided all the time in the occult. You have creatures like the Navajo skinwalkers going across the battlefield and tearing absolutely anything and everything up.
Okay.
One of the other things that we're actually previewing here at Gen Con is the first look at AE-Bounty. And AE for Bounty is Alien Encounters Bounty. For all those wondering what exactly it stands for. And Bounty is basically based on the same core mechanic as AE-WWII, so everybody who's already played AE-WWII already knows how to play AE-Bounty. What we've done is we mix it up a little bit. We've now got aliens, humans, fighting it on planets as well as in spaceships. The cool things we've done with Bounty is that in spaceship combat, you're fighting inside of ships where you can blow holes in the walls of spaceships to have them sucked out. You can also have personal teleporters on spaceships, but you run the risk of possibly teleporting outside of the ship. Really fun stuff.
Everyone
loves
that.
You can totally customize all of your heroes and all the characters in the game, so you can pretty much run any miniature that you own already, as well as the miniatures that we're going to be producing. That's all the information we've got right now.
How many, what scale? I mean, not only in size, I mean, how many guys in AE-Bounty? You know, the skirmish game?
Right. AE-Bounty has a, right now, scale-wise, you can go from anything from 2 miniatures for an assassin crew up to 20 miniatures for a pirate crew.
Okay.
So it really depends on what type of flair you want for your crews. Gear is highly customizable. You can include close combat monsters up to long-range guys.
Okay.
You can change the types of weapons as far as whether they're ballistic-based, laser, plasma, weapons, close combat weapons, monofilament blades, swords.
All the toys, excellent.
Variety of everything, as well as just tons of gear. I can't even list the amount of gear options that you can have so that no two crews will ever be the same.
Cool. And I know you've got a few minis out for that now, but you've got a... Is there any kind of schedule for when the rest is... It's going to be a line, right? It's going to be an ongoing deal.
Yeah, correct. AE-Bounty right now, it's going to be released in the next couple months. You'll get a solid rule book, and it's going to be the same size as a lot of the mini rule books we have out there from other companies. We want to keep it small, pocket size, so that you guys can bring it into your game and you don't have to worry about lugging around each book.
Oh, okay.
As far as miniatures right now, we have a very firm 36 sculpts in the line. That's 14 different alien races, as well as another 20-some-odd miniatures that are a mix of aliens and humans, and a mix of using both. As far as plans for Bounty, yeah, we've got a couple other books already planned out.
Even after the getting Bounty out was such a process, huh?
Yeah,
get back on the horse?
Yeah, anything cliche. There could be Robot Wars coming in.
Excellent, excellent. All right. how about for the occult expansion? I know some of the minis are out already. Yeah.
Correct. We already have started releasing figures for the occult expansion. Last month we released the British Greenhand, Ghost British Generation, and the SS Werewolf. This month we've at Gen Con we've already got the ROA figures. There's four of them, which is the Russian Liberation Army,
right,
landing faction of Soviets using German weaponry.
Fabulous. Sure. All right. Well, thanks for taking the time. Really appreciate it. And I guess that's about all we got for Darkson from Gen Con.